Hey, do you know what the most common cause of facial nerve surgery is in my office? That's what we're going to talk about now. Currently, the majority of facial nerve surgeries I perform are a result of removing a tumor located in the inner ear, specifically known as an acoustic neuroma. These procedures involve delicate microsurgery techniques. This type of tumor is benign most of the time, but since it is located inside the inner ear, which is a part of bone very close to the facial nerve and the nerve responsible for hearing, the main consequences of removing this tumor are loss of facial movement and hearing loss. In this delicate procedure, the skilled skull-based neurosurgeon carefully removes the lesion while leveraging neuromonitoring techniques to safeguard the function of critical structures. However, the injury can still occur unexpectedly. If it happens, we have two scenarios. The first is where the neurosurgeon tells us that he made a lesion of the facial nerve that was inevitable because the tumor, for example, invaded the facial nerve. In this case, we went straight to the reconstruction surgery. In cases where the neurosurgeon assured he spared the nerve, yet the patient developed paralysis, we monitor the progress of his recovery over the coming months to assess any improvement. Close to a year after the injury, if the patient does not have a satisfactory recovery, or if their electroneurobiography exam, for example, does not show signs of reinnervation, this patient also has a surgical indication. In this particular scenario, the facial muscles of the patient are showing viability, indicating that we have the opportunity to utilize a nearby nerve for reinnervation. We have two choices available. The first one is this one here, the chewing nerve, which is a branch of the trigeminal, the masseter. We perform a meticulous reconstruction where we use specialized techniques to rebuild the facial nerve that is lacking energy. The second possibility is the hypoglossal nerve, which is the nerve that moves the tongue. We have other nerves that perform the same function, so the patient does not have sequelae from these procedures and still has the chance to improve facial movements. It is very important to understand that these surgeries have only a certain time to be performed, and after a year and a half of injury, the chances of success decrease drastically. Procedure execution method? He is less invasive than the first surgery because it is not an intracranial procedure, it is extracranial. It is done under general anesthesia, and the neurosurgeon specializes in peripheral nerves, needing a microscope to make the connection between these donor nerves, which are healthy and functional, and the recipient nerves, which is the facial nerve. We suture these nerves with a very thin thread, thinner than hair. After the procedure, the patient will take care of the surgical scar, and after 21 days, rehabilitation begins. It is not a rehabilitation equal to facial recovery when they did not undergo surgery. It is crucial to understand that the nerve energy of the face primarily originates from other nerves, including the chewing nerve responsible for jaw movement and the tongue nerve for taste and speech. Therefore, it is very important for you to have a specialized team in facial rehabilitation to undergo recovery after this surgical procedure. I am Dr. Thomas Marcolini, a neurosurgeon specialized in facial nerve reconstruction, and I have a large post-operative rehabilitation team. I practice in Curitiba and in Sao Paulo, the capital. If you're interested in scheduling an appointment and gaining further insights on facial paralysis, feel free to reach out to us through our contact details and designated channel.